In order to use Git for a specific folder, no, we have this web project. It's just a folder, a simple folder. There is no versioning. And you need to use the Git command. And personally, I use the Git CLI. You know, and if you are not a CLI command, or if you don't like using command lines in general, you can install a GUI. You can install a GUI software. But in general, if you are interested by installing the Git CLI, you can go into this URL right here and download it for the Mac user, Windows, or Linux user. You can just pick one, then install it. And to check if Git is installed, open the terminal on your machine and use Git version, and it will give you the latest version that you already installed, and that's good. Now, I suppose that Git is already in your machine. How to enable this web project, which has some files on it, to use Git. Okay, to enable Git for this web project, you just need to use Git init. And this Git init, as you already see here from the message, initializes empty Git repository. Now we have a Git repository, and in what? In a folder.git. And if we go to this .git folder, so when I use this ls, you see that I don't have this Git folder. I need to use this ls all, so to list me all of the folder, even the hidden one, because this .git folder is a .git folder, which ls will not list it. And once I enter to this cd.git folder, you will see here that I have some files and folders. And these files and folders are used to gather the information on whatever you are using and of the Git commands, because you will start getting using Git command, Git status, and some other commands to track all of this information or to track everything. So all of that will be stored within this .git folder. And this is what you need to take. This .git folder gather the history and the information about the project, and you can track everything within the .git folder. You don't have to do that manually, but the Git command will help us to do that. But if you just remove, if for example you remove this .git folder, which means now this web project, you can't use any command. Okay, let's just do that again. If I use Git init, it will create a .git folder, then I can use the commands. For example, if I use this Git status right here, which gives us some information about untracked files, once I use this Git status, so it gives me this information. But why? From where it gets this information is from the Git folder, okay? But if I remove this .git folder, then I will use the Git status again. So as you see here, I have not a Git repository. Why? Because there isn't a .git folder to gather this information from. But what if I create it manually? Let's just create this folder manually. Now I have this .git folder manually. So this Git status will work? For sure not, because we don't have the structure of all of the files within this .git folder. And Git init, once you are using it, let's just remove this .git, which will create it manually. And this Git init, when you are using it, it just creates, let's just enter to .git now, it creates a structure of files, and so when Git can gather all of this information, so you can do that manually. Okay, let's just summarize all of that. You use Git init, okay, I'll remove it again. Use Git init to enable Git for a specific project. This is a folder, and you want to enable Git to be used for this specific folder, and you want to gather the history and the information, and you want to enable and stop using Git for a specific folder, use Git init. Once you are using it, it's create a Git folder. Okay, the second thing, if you want to remove, or if you decide that a web project, and you don't want to just using Git anymore for this project, you can remove the Git folder by using rm or by removing it manually. Once you are removing it, you will lose everything. Yeah, you will lose literally everything. But what I mean by that, you lose the histories and everything you are doing. You'll only have access to the latest version of your web project. Okay, before removing the .git folder, you need to know exactly what you are doing. This isn't just about removing the folder, okay? Now, but sometimes, let's just initialize that. Sometimes you want a copy of this web project, okay, but without this .git folder. For that, you can just copy the folder web project and create another project, for example, project no versioning or whatever. Okay, now we can have, when I enter this web project, I have Git. Now, when I enter this web project, no versioning, I just need to remove Git from this folder. Now I can have a copy, once that use Git and once that doesn't use Git. Okay, just keep in mind that. Be aware when you want to remove the .git folder because you will lose everything.